But again, it just gives you a good feel of the manipulation and just the gripper opening and closing. We'll put those blocks back on in a minute. It can give you just some of the, maybe the general tasks that it has, the capability to do, and you can program it to do a whole assortment of tasks, obviously. One question I will ask is, how many people know in the robotics world what the difference between a cobot and an industrial, like a regular industrial robot, is? Anybody? So the big key factor here with a cobot versus like a standard industrial robot is that the force sensing capability that all the joints have built into them makes it extremely safe, so that if you're actually to get in the way or it hits an obstacle it's not supposed to encounter, obviously like a human or a worker, where if I was standing here at this table performing a task as well alongside of this, it becomes extremely safe then, because all it does when it does encounter something is it initiates a protective stop. And on the screen then, you have the option to either, you know, log that in a report, you can just simply enable the robot again, you hit play, and it's just off to doing what it was doing before. If it senses too hard of a collision, it may actually fault the